I said it before, and I gotta say it again, because the fact that it's even still happening is actually kind of mind-blowing. The Nintendo Switch has had the best launch year I've ever seen a game console have, and probably the best of any game console ever created. If you haven't bought a Nintendo Switch yet, you need to fix that, because, man, you are missing out on the definite highlight of 2017. 2017's been pretty good. It's had some missteps, but nothing is perfect. In terms of gaming, that is, obviously, EA is in the final minute of 2017 trying to drag the entire year down with it. But Nintendo has provided the non-stop highlights of 2017 in terms of gaming. And the fact... Listen, just Doom for Switch, it's not perfect. I do want to talk about it right now a little bit. It's definitely has some issues, I think, in the hit detection frame rate department. But it is a great port, and the fact, again, it is on the Switch is really, really impressive. L.A. Noire, I haven't seen too much footage from L.A. Noire on Switch, but I haven't heard really any bad things about it. Obviously, Super Mario Odyssey is incredible. You gotta play that game. Mario Rabbids, definitely the sleeper hit, if you would, of 2017. Mario Rabbids Kingdom Battle. Definitely don't pass that up. Just because it has the Rabbids. I was a little worried about the Rabbids, but the Rabbids actually aren't bad. They're great. That game's great. Great entry into the strategy RPG genre. Breath of the Wild, it's game of the year. What more do you want? I love that game. If you love open world games, that's for you. And then again, Doom fills an FPS need. LA Noire gives you an open world, really a point and click almost, like investigation game, if you want to put it that way. And then, of course, Splatoon and ARMS for a little more of variety, fighting and third-person shooter action. Then the upcoming game, because we've been missing one big thing, and that's been the RPGs. Here comes Xenoblade Chronicles 2 in just a couple days. I feel like this is the game that if it comes out and it gets those reviews, gets great player reviews, gets great... critical reviews, of course. This is the game that it ties it all together. It puts the little bow on top, if you would. Xenoblade Chronicles 2 has a ton riding on it, because I feel like this is the game that no one's paying a ton of attention to, but I think everybody's looking at it. Like, nobody's like overhyping it, but they're all aware that it's coming. And they're keeping their eyes on it. And this could be the game that cements the Switch as being totally worthy of being it, like being PS4 and Xbox One level, if you would. Everyone's keeping an eye on Xenoblade Chronicles 2. Trust me on that. And if it kills it, if it's a great game, I think the Switch goes to like, it takes that next level. It goes to the next level. It takes the leap that I think it will even sway the naysayers, if there are any. Still, I'm sure there are, because Nintendo, for some reason, keeps getting shit from people that doesn't make any sense at all. But I think if Xenoblade Chronicles 2 kills it, you've got something for everyone, and... It's going to be insane if Xenoblade Chronicles 2 can manage to be the third massive hit that Nintendo could have in under a year. And I think it could do it. I think it definitely could do it if it lives up to Xenoblade Chronicles 1, which has its issues but is a great game. Xenoblade Chronicles X, which unfortunately was on the Wii U, which I think kind of shot itself in the foot by being on the Wii U, but... It was a great game in and of itself as well. But Xenoblade Chronicles 2, I think, has a ton riding on it. And it could be It could be insane if Xenoblade Chronicles 2 delivers anything near like what Odyssey and Breath of the Wild can do. This is Jeff from Studio 41 Gaming. Thanks for watching.